After a pulsating series of races, it was the final short track event of Vancouver 2010, the men's 5,000-meter relay. The A-final was just a few minutes away, with the Olympic champions South Korea taking on a very strong Canadian team, plus China, the USA, and France. But first, there was the B-final, with just two teams in it, Germany and Great Britain. The event taking place in the city's Pacific Coliseum. So Germany off in front. There were four skaters per team. Each team member had to do at least one lap. And when it came to an exchange, the two team members involved would have to touch. The oval measured 111.12 meters, and they do 45 laps to complete the race. And now they were approaching the finish with Germany in the lead by several meters. Surely too much of a gap for Great Britain to make up. But the man with a mission was John Ely from Solihull. Ahead of him, Tyson Hjung, the anchorman for Germany. The two of them had met in the B final of the 500 meters. Hjung had been quicker then, but Ely was flying now on the final lap and taking a great line round the bend. And John Ely was in for the victory. His attack carried out to perfection. The Koreans would have been proud of that. It was a superb fight back from the 25-year-old. The man who played international ice hockey simply refused to be beaten. And it was a great moment for the British team. Tom Iverson, Jack Welborn, Anthony Douglas, and John Ely. Winners of the B final, the 5,000 meters relay. But now for the A final and the battle for the Olympic medals. Five teams on the ice. Song Wei Long starting for China, Olivier Jean for Canada, Sang Si Bak for Korea, Thibaut Fauconnet for France, and J.R. Selsky for the United States, back from a five-month layoff after a blade sliced his leg open. The first change after a lap and a half, and Han Jialiang in the lead for China, followed by Charles Hamlin, Canada's 500 meters champion. And going into the final changeover, it was Trombley for Canada, Han for China, America third with Apollo Ono, and the Koreans, the Olympic champions, still back in fourth, with Kwak Yoon-gi a lot of work to do. The final lap, Canada leading from China, but Korea moving into third down the back straight. Still Canada in front, though, as Kwak muscled his way past the Chinese. But Hamlin was home and hosed. Canada had got the gold medal. The Koreans had left it too late. And the Americans in third place. Trombley had brought home the title. Korean disappointment. The Americans would be on the podium. But what a night for the four Canadians. The Chinese unluckily out of the medals. Around the curve, Han was in second place, but there was contact with the Korean, and suddenly, he was in the barrier. His skate seemed to catch the Korean's hand, and then Ono, the American, wrestling Kwak for second place, but the Korean resisting over the line. So the flags flying in the Pacific Coliseum as the Canadians celebrated two victories on the final day of the Olympic short track program. First, the men's 500 meters, and now the relay. So once again, the Canadians had proved themselves masterful in the relay. They'd won the Olympic title at Nagano and at Salt Lake City, and now they'd done it at home in Canada. Silver to South Korea, and bronze to the United States, including an eighth Olympic medal for Apollo Ono. And as he said, the nice thing about an Olympic medal is, it's for life, it never goes away.